Hello there, my fellow Minecraftians, and you're back with IDED of IDEDOnline, and today we're going to be looking at Food Plus, the basics. This will be a two-part tutorial series covering basically everything in Food Plus, which is included in Attack of the Bee Team. So the first thing you're going to want to look at when you get into this mod is the knife. This is one of the main components you'll use, and to make this knife, what you're going to need is a stick and an iron ingot, and you just place that diagonally above the stick itself there, the iron ingot, and that'll produce you the knife. Now, what's the knife used in? Well, it's used in this, the worktop, which will allow you to make pretty much most or almost all of the items involved in Food Plus. And you'll see here, this is the interface looking like a standard crafting station, but is actually required to actually craft most of the food. So, to make one of these, what you're going to need is your knife in the top central point there. You'll need a crafting table in the very middle there, and then surround that with cobblestone in a U-shape, and that'll pop you out one of these worktops. Now, moving on to a first item, I'm going to show you basically all of the basic components first for food, and then we'll go into the more advanced recipes. So starting off with one of my favourites, cheese. Of course, now cheese, it gives you back 2 hunger, as you can see there. It has a requirement of the worktop to be crafted. There's what it looks like in game. And to craft that, all you're going to need is a bucket of milk right there in the centre. I believe it's actually a shapeless crafting recipe, so you can put it anywhere within the crafting UI, and it'll pop out this cheese for you. So next up is a little bit of an advanced version of that, which is butter. Yes, I know. Sky does Minecraft, eat your heart out. It's real butter, not just claiming that gold's butter. So this one actually restores hunger of one, and of course requires the worktop, and there's where it looks like there actually looks like butter. So to make this, what you're going to need is a milk bucket in the direct center here, and then on all four sides of it there, you're going to need sugar. So that's above, below, on the right and left of it, you're going to need those, and that will produce you one of these butter. So next up is bread slice. Yes, bread slice. Now this is a way to actually sort of elongate the usage of your bread, and this is going to restore one hunger if you eat it. Now for this, you just need the knife there below and the bread just above it, and that'll pop you out 3 slices of bread, so you can keep on making your more of your actual normal bread into multiple slices. So moving on, so we've got toast, and this actually restores 2 hunger, so the bread restores 1, this one will restore 2, and what you're going to need is a furnace, not just the worktop for this one, and as you can see there it is, so it looks pretty much like the bread slice, just a little bit burnt. But yeah, to make this, all you're going to need is to put a bread slice into your furnace, obviously heating that while using any sort of ingredient you want to use, like coal or sticks or wood or anything like that, and that'll pop you out this toast. So moving on, let's have a look at chips. Now chips is a favourite of everyone's, I know, and this will restore two hunger, even though you're going to be eating it in raw form if you eat it like this, but you can cook these, and it requires the worktop. So to make chips, all you need is 3 potatoes like that, diagonally placed across the work surface, and that will give you these chips. Now moving on, flour. Now it's a base component to make some of the other items in there, and it will restore no hunger because you can't actually eat flour as a raw component, but it does require the worktop. And to make flour, you're just going to need to put your wheat is like that, and it's a shapeless crafting, so as long as you've got 4 pieces of wheat into the actual crafting table or into the worktop, then you'll get 6 flour back out of it. Now moving on, this is the filter. Now this is actually used for doing coffee bits and pieces as well, but this is one of the main components you're going to need for some of the other bits that are coming up next. So the filter itself, as you can see there, uses the worktop, and you'll need to put it like this. So you have a little bowl shape basically of iron ingots with a piece of paper in the direct center of it there, and that'll pop you out one of these filters. Now, why are you going to use that for? You're going to use it to get salt. So salt actually restores 1 hunger if you're going to decide to eat salt raw. I know it's a bit of an unusual option. I don't think I'd go for that myself, but you can. You can just eat the salt as is. And so to get this, all you need is a bucket of water like that, and obviously your filter right below it there. Put that into the worktop, and that'll pop you out 3 salt. Now, next up is tomato sauce. Yes, tomato sauce. And this you can once again eat as a raw component, and it will restore 1 hunger. But obviously you can use this for different recipes later, so it's worth holding on to. To get this, you need to put 2 tomatoes and a glass bottle into the actual crafting UI of your worktop, and that'll pop you out 2 of these tomato sauces. So 1 glass bottle multiplies into 2. Magical. So moving on. Now it's got chocolate. Now chocolate is obviously something that's definitely new, but something that's been around in Minecraft for quite a long time. As you remember, the cocoa beans. Well, this will restore 2 hunger if you eat it as a raw component here. And to make chocolate, all you're going to need is cocoa beans like that all the way around, and sugar in the direct center, and that'll pop you out 3 chocolate. So moving on, we've got spaghetti. Yes, this is the raw form of spaghetti that you can use, and this restores no hunger, so you can't actually eat this as a raw component as by itself. But there we go, so that's what it looks like. It's got kind of like string, but just in a slightly yellow color. And to make this, what you're gonna need is flour like that, free of it, and a piece of water there, basically a water bucket up in the top corner, and flour surrounding it like that. And that'll produce you four spaghetti. So moving on, we've got the sausage. Yes, sausage. It's finally a good use for some of those pork. But yes, it restores four hunger and requires the worktop to be made. And to make a sausage, you just need to put two raw pork chops into the crafting UI. And there you go, it'll pop out one of these sausages. Next up is the fried egg. And it restores two hunger if you eat just by itself there, fried egg. You need a furnace for this one. And all you need to do is put the egg into the furnace. And there you go, it pops out a fried egg. The shell just magically disappears. So moving on again, we've got cooked mutton. Yes, mutton. So if you actually kill a sheep, you should actually get mutton dropped in like a mod packs like Attack of the Bee Team, and this will restore free hunger if you eat this here. And it requires a furnace. You just put your raw mutton into the furnace there, heat it with whatever you need to, and there you go, you get cooked mutton out the other side. Moving on, you've got the beaten egg. Yes, you almost guess how this one's made, but it restores free hunger if you eat this. So eating a raw egg, yes, gives you free hunger. And you need the worktop for this one, and it magically gets a bowl out of nowhere, you see. So basically all you need to do is put an egg into your crafting UI of the worktop, and out comes a beaten egg. Now, next up is a cooked carrot. Yes, carrots can finally be cooked, and this restores free hunger if you eat it. All you need is the furnace. You put your carrot in there, put your fuel in the bit there, and that'll pop out one of these cooked carrots. Next up is a bowl of rice. Now it gives you four hunger restored if you eat this. And to make this, what you're going to need is your worktop, and you're going to put free rice in there like that across the direct center. Put a bowl in the middle below it there, and that'll pop you out a bowl of rice. Now moving on, you can actually make rice into fried rice. Yes, and this restores five hunger, so it's a good improvement from the four there. And all you need to do is cook it. So you put your bowl of rice in, and it comes out as fried rice. And believe it or not, the bowl is indestructible and doesn't get damaged during the heating. But yes, you can advance that even further with a bowl of rice with meat. And this actually restores 10 hunger, so basically double the amount of the fried rice. Now to get this, what you're going to need is your bowl of rice there in the bottom center. You're going to need a piece of steak, some seeds, and a cooked chicken. So those three across the center like that, and your bowl of rice below, and that'll pop you out this bowl of rice with meat. But there's other options. Just in case you're one of those veggies, you can get a bowl of rice with vegetables, and this actually restores 8 hunger, so not quite as good as meat because there's no protein in it, you see. And you need the worktop to make this one. Now to make this, you need your bowl of rice at the bottom there, you'll need a tomato directly above it there, a carrot this side, and a potato that side, and that'll pop you out one of these bowl of rice with veggies. But there's still other options. You could go for the classic student style meal. You can have rice with tomato sauce. Yes, rice with tomato sauce. It will restore 6 hunger, and all you need is your tomato sauce, which you covered earlier, and a bowl of rice, and that'll pop you out this rice with tomato sauce. Now, next up is another use for the rice, which is sushi. Yes, if you like to eat some raw fish, sushi's always an option. So getting a little bit oriental with it. And this restores 4 hunger and requires the worktop to be made. And there you go, you can see it there. Now, to make sushi, what you're going to need is seaweed, which you can collect from the ocean, rice itself, and of course some raw fish, which you can get from fishing. And that'll make you your sushi if you put that into your worktop. Moving on, here's french fries. Now if you remember the chips from earlier that we covered, well, these will restore free hunger, and if you put them in the furnace, so that was the chips from earlier, there you go, and you cook those in your furnace, and it pops out these french fries. So moving on, you can get crisps from french fries, believe it or not. I don't understand how they turn from french fries into crisps, but still, nonetheless, this restores 5 hunger and requires the worktop. All you're going to need to do is get 6 lots of the french fries in the crafting UI like that, and this will produce you 4 bags of crisps. Moving on, you can also use the chips to make yourself some steak and chips, which is a great meal if you ask me, and it restores hunger of 7. It uses the worktop, and that's what it looks like there. Now to make this, all you need is a piece of steak in the direct center, and then surround it with french fries like that, and that'll create you steak and chips. Next up is the fish and chips. Yes, fish and chips. And it's a hunger 6 restoration there, and requires the worktop to be crafted. Now, to make yourself fish and chips, all you need to do is put some cooked fish into the direct center of the worktop UI, and then surround that with french fries there, and that'll create you some fish and chips with 2 lots of it there. Same as the steak. Now, you can also get egg and bacon. So if you remember the fried egg from previous, well, this is the version that you can use it with to create it to give you more hunger restoration. This restores 5 hunger. So you can get bacon by just killing pigs. pigs around the world, and it gives you the already cooked version of the bacon, unless you're using a more advanced version of the mod where you actually have to cook it yourself. But to get this, all you're going to need to do is put your egg and your bacon into the Worktop UI, and it'll craft you the egg and bacon. But there's a different version of it you can use in a second, and this is after we show you how to make the grilled sausage. Now, if you remember the sausage from earlier, well, this is the grilled sausage. It restores hunger of 5 and requires a furnace, and that's what it looks like there. All you need to do is put the sausage into your furnace, heat it up, and there you go, you get a grilled sausage out of it. Now, moving on, is to the egg and sausage show. We had egg and bacon, why not egg and sausage? Restores 5 hunger and requires the Worktop. Yes, I know, it doesn't give you any improvement over the grilled sausage, but still, it looks a little bit nicer, doesn't it? So, to make this, all you need is to put your egg and your grilled sausage both into the UI of the Worktop, and there you go, you get egg and sausage. Moving on to ketchup. Ketchup is a great condiment to have with any meal, I reckon, and you can get this. Now, you can't eat it as a raw component because it's ketchup. Why would you want to eat ketchup as a raw component? What's wrong with you? But still, nonetheless, to get this, all you're going to need to do is get yourself some tomato sauce and some salt, basically what it uses in real life to make tomato ketchup. Put those two together and it'll pop you out a bottle of ketchup. Now, what can you use ketchup for? Well, it's for the hot dog, yes. This restores hunger of 7 and requires the Worktop to be crafted. Now, as you can see from the picture there, it magically gets mustard too. So you don't have to craft the mustard. It'll magically build it for you. But still, nonetheless, all you need for this is your ketchup in the top middle there, your grilled sausage in the direct center of the Worktop UI, and a piece of bread slice either side. And that'll give you a hot dog. Now, moving on, you can get sandwich bread. Yes, sandwich bread. You can eat this and it's hunger 1. It's kind of like the bread slice, but it's slightly different crafting recipe for this one. So, sandwich bread, it just requires you salt in the direct center of the table, and then along the bottom, 3 lots of flour like that, and it'll pop you out 4 slices of sandwich bread. Now, you can actually make yourself a sandwich with the sandwich bread, believe it or not. And this restores hunger of 10. It's an amazingly well-efficient piece of food, as you can see there. It requires the Worktop to be crafted, and to make this, what you're going to need is sandwich bread at the top and the bottom in the middle, and then you need a tomato, a cooked chicken, and a carrot in there, and that'll pop you out one of these sandwiches. Now, moving on, you can get bread and butter pudding. Yes, bread and butter pudding is a classic, and restores a hunger of 4. Requires the Worktop to be crafted, and as you can see it there. Now, to make this, all you're going to need is 6 pieces of bread, so 6 bread slices across the top and the bottom like that, and that will actually give you the enough to do this. Now, all you need is 2 basically loaves of bread cut up with your knife to make this, and then you need milk bucket on this side here, butter in the center, and salt next to it there, and that will produce you the bread and butter pudding. Now, moving on, you can have bread with butter. Yes, bread with butter restores hunger of 2. So basically, it's toast with butter on it. But to make that, all you're going to need is yourself some butter in the direct center of your crafting UI like that, and a piece of toast directly below it. And that'll pop you out this breaded, well, buttered bread. Next up, Nutella. Yes, Nutella. Who doesn't love the chocolatey sauce that you can spread on toast? And it restores hunger of 3 if you just eat a jar of Nutella. To make this, all you're going to need is some chocolate, a butter just directly below it there, and milk bucket directly below that. So you've got chocolate, butter, and milk bucket directly below, and there we go, you get yourself some Nutella. Now, you can use Nutella to spread it on your toast, so you can get bread with Nutella, which restores a hunger of 4. Now, it needs the Worktop UI to craft it, and that's what it looks like there. Now, to make this, all you're going to need to do is put your Nutella in the direct center of your Worktop UI and put the toast directly below it, and it turns the toast back from being toast into bread, so you get bread with Nutella. Moving on though to mashed potato. Yes, this restores a hunger of 2. Now, to craft this, you just need to put some butter in the top middle of your Worktop UI. You need to put a potato in the direct center of the UI and a bowl directly below that, and that'll create you some mashed potato. Now, moving on to apple pie. Apple pie is a classic one. It restores a hunger of 4 and requires the Worktop to be crafted. All you need is sugar, apple, and an egg there, straight across the center like that, and that'll pop you out one of these apple pies. So, moving on. This is the kebab. Yes, kebab restores a hunger of 9, so it's quite a good one. And to make this, all you're going to need is toast either side of the center there, so you can see, a piece of salt on the top, a steak in the middle, and a tomato below that, and there you go. You've got yourself a kebab. No, no salad in this one. No lettuce, apparently. So it's just a good old hearty kebab. And the last recipe we're going to cover for this tutorial, but we will cover more in part 2, is the hamburger. Yes, restoring a hunger of 6. And this one's a nice simple one. You just get a steak, 2 bread slices, 1 above and 1 below like that, put it together, and it turns into a hamburger with apparently lettuce in it too. So there's magical lettuce in this mod. And then, so stick with us for the next episode. We'll do part 2 very soon, which will cover some of the slush puppies, soda cans, some of the pasta dishes, and all the other bits and pieces available to you in Food Plus. So I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. I hope you found it useful. And remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed it. Until next time, I've been IDED, and I'll catch you soon.